Welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. Joining me now is the CEO of GINSGLOBAL Index Fund, Anthony Ginsberg. And Anthony, good to see you again. How are you?
Great to be with you, Steve.
Good stuff. Well, excited to get an update on what's going on with your Tech Megatrend ETF. And I know sometimes it can be a bit of a challenge looking at the megatrend and where it's going to come from. And that's why this specific fund, you've really done a good job at trying to pick a number of different areas.
Yes, it was actually up almost 46% last year, but it's far less concentrated than many of our competitors. We're essentially equally weighting 120 holdings, Steve. And those 120 come from 15 leading players across each of these eight sub-themes. So from cybersecurity to cloud, to AI, robotics, even blockchain, electric vehicles. So it's a bit broader than just your traditional IT funds. We're even covering things like gaming. And there's a lot of conversions across the board. We've seen firms like Microsoft, which, as you know, hit a $3 trillion market cap. They've actually bought the largest gaming company to date for $75 billion last year. So, and they see that as a social media / online gaming play. So it's very hard to time these individual sub-themes. I mean, cloud's done great over the last year and a half as well. It's up over 40%+. But the truth is, a lot of these things do overlap, and cybersecurity and cloud are almost like brothers. And then you're seeing a lot more M&A activity. Digital gaming, for instance, is now five times larger than the movies or Hollywood, where I'm based. So it's very hard to time individually. Sometimes they work cyclically, but it's already a global story, Steve. Only 60% of Tech Megatrend is actually US based. So it just tells you how much of an international story it really is.
Yeah, and you were talking a little bit about cybersecurity and cloud and the emergence of cloud and how popular it's been and how companies are utilizing it, but also that obviously puts their data at risk. And that's, I guess, what you were suggesting, that you're seeing such a big rise in cybersecurity.
Yes, and actually the work from home phenomenon and the online gaming, all of that is actually already tailwinds for both cybersecurity and cloud, because most companies just don't have the speed and frankly, the flexibility to have the latest data, and also to run AI and algorithms. I know we've chatted before about this. You actually need a very, very fast server and environment to do that. And most of the big Fortune 500s and highly regulated industries, banks, insurers, healthcare, are now outsourcing their data and running these algos and large language models, LLMs, et cetera, through cloud providers. Essentially, they're able to dial up or dial down their usage. So it provides a lot more flexibility. But I wouldn't discount the fact that things like onshoring, which is a huge trend here in the US, is pushing the valuations of robotics companies up. So that's another area we look at. Obviously, the streaming companies have done very, very well. Netflix in particular had record subscription gains and earnings. So I wouldn't be surprised if you see more M&A activity across a number of these eight sub-themes that we're exposed to. And again, we're broader than just your traditional IT sector, which today is limited much to semiconductors and maybe software companies. We see this as a whole digital disruption space. So there are basically eight key sub-themes, including genetic, genomics, we call it, or genetic engineering. So that's healthcare innovation. So it's across the board from EVs all the way to AI and robotics, cyber and cloud.
And so just on that, Anthony, just want to get that one point across that you mentioned. So you feel there is going to be a lot of M&A activity this year, especially when companies are struggling and ones that are doing a little bit better, they look at opportunity to increase their market share. So you expect that to happen this year?
Well, we do, partly because the interest rates are going to be coming down, so it's easier to finance certain acquisitions, although many of the largest players are sitting on mountains of cash. I mean, this is very different to 2000, when some of the guys may not have had that situation. The other thing is that the PE ratios are very, very different to what happened 20 odd years ago. We basically are sitting with, our tech Megatrend's only got a PE of about 18 and a half, 19. So we're not at expensive levels. Many, many of these companies are still at 2021 levels. Other than the Magnificent Seven, you see many companies still at pre-2021 levels. So there's still good value out there in the mid-cap and large-cap space. The mega-caps, some of them have run quite hard. But overall, the PE ratios are relatively low. In, as I say, Tech Megatrend, in our case, below 20.
Wow. Exciting times for sure, Anthony. Really appreciate your time as well. Thanks very much. Good to see you. We'll talk again.
Thank you, Steve.
All right, Anthony Ginsberg, the CEO of GINSGLOBAL Index Fund.